Hot plasma sizzled inches from Dennis Gordon's bloody, dirt-caked face as he ducked behind the mangled wreckage of an alien fighter, clutching his pulse rifle. The horrific war-consuming planet Zephyrus had just claimed his entire squad in a ruthless alien onslaught. Charred limbs and sightless eyes lay strewn around the hellish battlefield. A gargantuan fireball suddenly blossomed across the smoke-choked sky. The Retribution, one of Earth's last remaining warships, had sacrificed itself in a kamikaze run, ramming a Zarantine dreadnought. The cataclysmic blast momentarily stunned the murderous aliens advancing on all fronts. Seizing the split-second lull, Dennis sprinted a quarter mile to a bombed-out bunker behind the jagged front lines. His boots pounded over rubble and his lungs heaved. He burst inside to find the battalion's shell-shocked officers arguing heatedly, their faces haggard and uniforms in tatters. Major Hawkins delivered the gut-wrenching news. Earth's space fleet had been utterly decimated, its shattered remnants fleeing hopelessly into the void. The merciless Zarantine would resume their final advance on Earth itself within days. Mankind's homeworld, teeming with billions of defenseless civilians, teetered on the brink of total annihilation. As the nightmarish reality sank in, a maddening memory flashed unbidden through Dennis's exhausted mind. The arrogant, sneering face of Zarantine Prince Vega before the Senate mere months ago. The sadistic alien had mockingly warned Earth's ambassadors that humanity's very existence depended solely upon the Zarantine's magnanimous whims. The bitter memories spun through Dennis's mind, fueling his rage against the Zarantine. Suddenly, sirens pierced through the ruminations, the bunker's proximity alarms wailing a dire warning. Dennis bolted to a flickering monitor, muttering curses under his breath. The screen showed a legion of Zarantine shock troops, their black chitin armor glimmering under the harsh sun, marching indomitably on the human fortifications. Wave after wave advanced, heedless of the smoldering husks of their fallen. "All units, defensive positions now! Get some fire on those bugs!" Dennis roared into the comms. Soldiers scrambled to man the perimeter guns, the staccato thunder of heavy repeaters and the searing crackle of plasma turrets erupting along the line. The Zarantine returned fire with a merciless plasma barrage, the superheated bolts hissing past to scorch deep holes in the ferrocrete. Dennis gathered his squad of grizzled veterans, locking eyes with each. "Flank 'em hard. Johnson Ramirez with me. The rest of you lay down covering fire and draw their attention." They nodded grimly and moved out, hugging the treacherous gulches and ridges to avoid detection. With curt hand signals, Dennis directed his men into position, surrounding the amassing alien horde. Each gripped a plasma grenade, thumbing the activation studs. At Dennis's signal, a dozen miniature suns flared to life amidst the Zarantine ranks. Aliens shrieked in agony as the grenades detonated, searing chitin and flesh to ash in blistering pulses of light and heat. In the next instant, Dennis and his squad opened up on full auto, pulse rounds stitching through the ranks of confused insectoid warriors. They pushed forward, pouring unrelenting fire into the aliens at point-blank range, not letting up until the last Zarantine lay twitching and gurgling in the blood-soaked dirt. Dennis paused to suck in a ragged breath, his armor pockmarked by plasma burns. Suddenly, Major Hawkins's voice crackled over the comms, laced with urgency. "Gordon, long-range sensors just lit up. Those bastards have a fleet moving into orbital positions. We've lost the anti-ship guns. I'm ordering a full retreat. Get to the evac site at the spaceport. Zephyrus is lost." Dennis raced through the rubble-choked streets, pulse rounds screeching past his head as the Zarantine closed in. Suddenly, he spotted a knot of civilians cowering behind a blasted-out storefront, pinned down by the aliens' relentless plasma fire. His heart lurched as he recognized his sister's terrified face, her arms wrapped protectively around her two small children. Without a second thought, Dennis charged towards them, his rifle roaring as he sent a hail of rounds tearing into the Zarantine lines. Chitin shattered and ichor sprayed, aliens crumpling like marionettes with their strings cut. Dennis reached the civilians and grabbed his sister's arm, hauling her to her feet. "Move now, stay low and don't look back," he barked. They ran, his niece and nephew clinging to him, their small faces streaked with tears and grime. Plasma bolts hissed and sizzled around them as they sprinted for the spaceport gates. Safety was just meters away when a searing lance of plasma caught Dennis in the shoulder, the force of the impact slamming him to the ground. His rifle clattered away, pain exploding through his senses. Through the haze of agony, he saw his sister's stricken face above him. "Go," he snarled through gritted teeth, shoving her towards the gate. "I'm right behind you." As she stumbled through the gates with the kids, Dennis pushed himself to his feet. The Zarantine were swarming towards him, their plasma rifles glowing with deadly charge. Dennis snatched up his gun and opened fire from the hip, buying himself precious seconds as the aliens scattered for cover. A rapid series of deafening booms suddenly split the air. Glancing up, Dennis saw fireballs blossoming amidst the Zarantine horde, scattering their broken bodies like leaves in a gale. Sleek human dropships roared overhead, their hulls emblazoned with the distinctive lightning bolt insignia of the Phantom Core. As the dropships touched down inside the spaceport perimeter, their rear ramps slammed down to disgorge squads of battle-hardened operators. They moved with fluid precision, fanning out to secure the area, weapons at the ready. A grizzled, scarred man strode up to Dennis, his rank insignia identifying him as a colonel. "Sergeant," he said curtly, "I'm Colonel Blackburn. We're here for a high-value extraction." "With respect, sir," Dennis growled. "We're all high-value targets now." The ghost of a smile flickered across Blackburn's weathered face. He gestured behind him, where a slight bespectacled man in a rumpled lab coat was hurrying down the dropship ramp, clutching a battered data pad. "Meet Dr. Elias Sorensen," Blackburn said. "He's the key to ending this goddamn war. We're getting him off this rock and back to Earth, no matter what it takes. I need you and your men on perimeter security." Dennis nodded, a savage grin splitting his face as he slammed a fresh magazine into his rifle. If this unassuming little man could really stick it to the Zarantine, then he'd walk through the fires of hell itself to keep him safe. "Lock and load, people," he roared to his squad. "We're on babysitting duty. Anything that's not human gets a pulse round facial copy." As they moved out, the battered remnants of the human forces rallied around the dropships, their weapons barking defiance at the oncoming alien swarms. Dr. Sorensen scurried to keep up, his face pale but determined. Dennis just hoped they had enough time for the good doctor to work his magic. The ragtag convoy reached one of the hangars, the huge blast doors groaning open to reveal a sleek black shape crouched inside, a Phantom Core stealth frigate, engines thrumming with barely restrained power. As the operators hustled Dr. Sorensen aboard, Dennis and his squad took up defensive positions around the ship. "Hold the line!" Colonel Blackburn roared over the crescendo of gunfire and alien shrieks. "Nothing gets through!" As the stealth frigate hurtled away from the hellscape of Zephyrus, the deck plates vibrated under Dennis's boots. In the cargo bay turned makeshift lab, Dr. Evan Roth hunched over a containment unit, his face bathed in an eerie blue glow. Inside, a viscous, oily substance swirled and pulsed as if alive. "What the hell is that, Doc?" Dennis growled, eyeing the strange sample warily. Roth glanced up, his eyes gleaming with a manic intensity. "Our salvation, Sergeant. A synthetic bioagent, reverse-engineered from Zarantine biotech, recovered by Phantom Core Black Ops. If I can stabilize it, weaponize it, it could target their physiology specifically, turn their own horrific creations against them." Before Dennis could reply, klaxons suddenly blared throughout the ship. He sprinted for the bridge, pulse rifle clutched tight. Colonel Blackburn was already there, his scarred face grim as he stared at the sensor display. "Zarantine cruiser, bearing down fast," he spat. "They've made us." The frigate's captain, a steel-haired veteran named Alvarez, swore under her breath. "Bringing weapon systems online. Prep for evasive maneuvers." But Dennis's blood ran cold as a chillingly familiar voice crackled over the comms. "Pathetic humans," Prince Vega sneered, his tone dripping with sadistic amusement. "Did you really think you could flee like cowards? I will tear your ship apart piece by piece and savor your screams as you die in the cold of the void." White-hot rage surged through Dennis's veins. his fists clenching until his knuckles cracked. But then an idea formed, as desperate as it was daring. He turned to Blackburn, his voice low and urgent. I have a plan. We EVA over, infiltrate that cruiser. Roth releases the bio-agent inside their own damn ship. Poetic justice. Blackburn's eyes narrowed, but he nodded curtly. Gear up, Phantoms! This is our chance to cut the head off the snake! Minutes later, Dennis and the hardened Phantom operators stood in the airlock, sealed into cutting-edge combat EVA suits. Dr. Roth, pale but determined, clutched a cylindrical device, the weaponized plague, ready for release. With a bone-jarring thunk, the airlock doors slammed open. Dennis leaped into the void, the Phantoms close behind, miniature thruster packs flaring as they hurtled towards the looming Zarantine cruiser. Immediately, space lit up with searing plasma fire, the cruiser's point defense cannons throwing up a blistering wall of destruction. The Phantoms wove and dodged, their armor scorched and pitted by near misses. Dennis gritted his teeth as a bolt sizzled past his helmet, close enough to sear his visor. At last, they slammed into the cruiser's hull, mag boots clanging against the alien metal. Plasma torches flared to life, cutting through the outer bulkhead like a hot knife through butter. They plunged into the ship, weapons primed and ready. All was eerie silence, the cruiser's corridors pulsing with dim bioluminescence. Then, with a skittering of chitin on metal, the Zarantine were upon them. Pulse rifles roared, flensing carapaces and splattering ichor. Dennis fought with a savage fury, his mind filled with the faces of the fallen, of worlds burned and billions butchered. They pushed deeper into the ship, a relentless tide of steel and wrath, leaving mounds of twitching Zarantine corpses in their wake. At last, they reached the bridge, the final bulkhead looming before them. With a thunderous detonation, the charges blew the reinforced door to atoms. Dennis charged through the smoke, rifle blazing. And there, amid the carnage, stood Prince Vega himself, a cruel smile on his chitinous face. "Are the little vermin scurrying aboard my ship?" he hissed. "I shall take great pleasure in crushing you beneath my heel." Vega's elite guard surged forward, their iridescent blades humming with deadly energy. The Phantoms met them head-on, the close confines of the bridge erupting into a vicious melee. Plasma blades clashed against nano-edged combat knives, chitin cracking under augmented human fists. Dennis fought like a man possessed, his armor ragged with slashes and dripping Zarantine blood. Vega's guards fell one by one, their heads shattered, limbs severed, ichor painting the bulkheads. At last, only Vega remained, his once pristine armor dented and scorched. Dennis lunged at him, a primal roar tearing from his throat. They grappled like titans, smashing through consoles in a shower of sparks. With a final desperate blow, Dennis caved in Vega's skull, his fist slamming through the crumpled chitin to pulp the alien's brain. The prince collapsed, black blood seeping from his shattered head. Staggering to the comms panel, Dennis hammered the transmit key. "Dock now!" On the frigate, Dr. Roth activated the bioweapon, his face set with grim determination. A sickly green mist began to fill the Zarantine ship, seeping into vents and curling through corridors. "Fall back!" Dennis roared to the surviving Phantoms. They fought their way back to their entry point, alien bodies shuddering and thrashing as the engineered plague ravaged their systems. At last, they reached the hull, mag boots pounding as they raced across the pitted surface. The frigate loomed ahead, airlock beckoning like the gates of heaven itself. Behind them, the Zarantine cruiser began to drift, escape pods erupting from its flanks like panicked insects. Dennis paid them no heed, his eyes fixed on the airlock, on salvation. With a final desperate leap, the Phantoms hurled themselves into the waiting airlock, the doors slamming shut behind them with a resonant boom. As they collapsed to the deck, chests heaving, the Zarantine cruiser receded into the distance, its running lights flickering and fading as the bio-plague consumed all within. The stealth frigate's engine screamed as it hurtled through the void, racing towards the besieged Earth. In the cramped, blood-spattered medbay, Dr. Roth worked feverishly over the synthesizer, his face gaunt and hands trembling with exhaustion. The surviving phantoms, their armor scorched and dented, watched in grim silence as the xenobiologist labored to mass-produce the lethal bioagent. "Come on, come on," Roth muttered, his voice ragged. "Just a little more." The synthesizer beeped, and a viscous green liquid began to fill the waiting canisters. Roth sagged back, a flicker of hope in his haunted eyes. "That's it," he breathed. "That's all we've got. Enough for one shot." On the bridge, the frigate's captain stared at the sensor display in horror. The Zarantine fleet hung in orbit around Earth like a swarm of bloated, malevolent insects, their dreadnoughts bristling with planet-cracking plasma cannons. "They're powering up weapons," the sensor officer reported, his voice trembling. "Estimating full charge in 2 minutes." The captain's jaw tightened. He turned to the comms officer, his eyes hard as flint. "Get me a secure link to Earth Command now." Moments later, a hologram flickered to life. A haggard, blood-streaked face, the insignia of an Earth Defense Force admiral, barely visible through the static. "Admiral," the captain said urgently, "the Zarantine are preparing to fire. We have a bioagent, but only enough for one strike. We need to take out their command ship." The admiral's eyes widened. "A bioweapon? My God, is it..." "It works," the captain said grimly. "Tested it myself on one of their cruisers, but we'll only have one shot." The admiral nodded slowly, the weight of billions of lives etched into the lines of his face. "Do it," he said. "Give those bastards hell and Godspeed." The hologram winked out. The captain turned to his crew, his voice ringing with grim resolve. "Load the bioagent into the stealth missile. We're going for the head of the snake." In the armory, Dennis stood before the sleek black shape of the missile, his face set like stone. Colonel Blackburn approached, his scarred visage grim. "You sure about this, Sergeant?" he asked quietly. "It's a one-way trip." Dennis met his gaze unflinchingly. "I'm sure. If this is what it takes to stick it to those alien fucks, then I'll gladly ride this thing straight into their ugly mugs." Blackburn clasped his shoulder, his grip fierce. "Give 'em hell, Dennis. We'll be right behind you, guns blazing." Dennis nodded, a savage grin splitting his face. He clambered into the missile's cramped cockpit, his hands flying over the controls. The bioagent canisters glowed an ominous green in the payload bay, the fate of humanity resting in their virulent depths. With a bone-jarring roar, the missile blasted free of the frigate, rocketing towards the Zarantine fleet. The alien dreadnoughts loomed before him, their hulls pulsing with malevolent energy. Suddenly, the void lit up with searing light. The dreadnoughts opened fire, their plasma cannons hurling sun-bright bolts of destruction towards the helpless Earth below. Cities vaporized in blinding flashes, continents cracking and buckling under the relentless onslaught. Dennis watched in horrified fury as his homeworld burned, billions of lives snuffed out in an instant. Tears of rage streaked his face as he slammed his fist down on the throttle, urging every last ounce of speed from the straining engines. The Zarantine command ship filled his viewscreen, its monstrous bulk bristling with weapons. Point defense lasers lashed out, stabbing at the oncoming missile with beams of searing light. Dennis gritted his teeth, sweat pouring down his face as he wrenched the controls, sending the missile into a dizzying spiral. With a roar of defiance, he slammed the nose of the missile directly into the command ship's hull. The bioagent canisters ruptured, a sickly green cloud billowing out to envelop the massive vessel. Almost immediately, the ship began to convulse, its lights flickering and hull plates shuddering as the virulent plague raced through its corridors. One by one, the other Zarantine ships began to drift, their crews succumbing to the bioagent's devastating touch. Plasma cannons fell silent, engines sputtering out as the fleet was transformed into a vast, orbiting graveyard. But it was too late for Earth. As Dennis watched, his heart shattering, the once vibrant planet lay in ruins, its surface a hellish patchwork of glowing craters and shattered continents, the cradle of humanity reduced to a lifeless husk. In the cockpit, Dennis felt a searing pain begin to blossom in his chest. He looked down to see tendrils of green snaking beneath his skin, the bioagent beginning its grim work. A bitter laugh escaped his lips, echoing in the confines of his helmet. They had won. The power of humanity's desperate, furious struggle had brought the mighty Zarantine low. But the cost had been everything. As the bioagent raced through his body, Dennis felt a strange peace descend over him. He had done his duty, had avenged the fallen. Earth, his family, his comrades, they could rest now. With a final shuddering breath, Dennis embraced the darkness. A grim smile etched onto his face. The last human witness to the end of an era, and the herald of a new, uncertain age. The stars watched in silence as the Zarantine fleet drifted lifelessly, the remnants of humanity's once great civilization scattered across the blasted earth below. In the void, the guttering flames of man's defiance faded, leaving only the cold, uncaring expanse of space. You have reached the end of the story. If you enjoyed this story and want to support us, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel, and for every comment that says 88, I will heart every single one of them. Thank you for your time.